felt that. I don't wanna be without you, cause I can't hardly breathe without you. This is why. How did I become the wrong side of the love song? Woo! How do you get there? You'll be there and you not even know that that's where you had it. You know what I mean? Or Lil Luther or Big Luther?
Oh, girl, Big Luther.
Big Luther.
And thought she could replace you. We got along just fine, but wasted time because she was not you.
Oh!
There what? You go. I felt that shit.
I felt that because what?
Because she was not you. Juanita. Though we knew we was faking, cause she a fake one. Love was so busy looking outside of their relationship for something that's already there.
It's already there.
Italian Ice, y'all have his Facebook page. We are coming back out with the same flavors from last year. The only ice cream that we're gonna probably do and promote really big and heavily because it was a big seller was that Laffy Taffy Banana.
So hello, 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 and welcome to this week's episode of I Felt That. Hey y'all, it's your girl Tara Nashe, and I'm back for episode 7. As you can see, I got a new guest here with me today. We got Miss Nita.
That's right.
She's going to help us reflect on some of this good old R&B music from the 90s and 2000s. She's a music lover.
Definitely.
And I'm going to go ahead and let her tell us a little bit about herself and how long she's been a music lover.
You know, honestly, I think I loved music ever since I was born.
And
because
that's what I
my
feel.
Mom played the best songs. And it was always heart to heart.
Yes.
With her.
Yes.
And they always had meanings.
They always
like
had
they
meanings.
Always came through.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's what it like most of it is. When we were growing up, we heard this good music.
Man.
So then when we got adults, it's like we got that music and then the stuff that helped us to get through.
Oh, you know where it came from, right? Them old black moms get to clean the house and the music. When the music came on, you knew to
that's
get your
what,
butt
up.
It
was time to get up and help clean up.
In time.
Saturday yeah. morning.
Man.
Get up. You heard that music.
It was like that music.
You know what it is. Get up.
Girl.
But honestly, it puts you in a happy mood.
It really do.
You know what I mean? Like, so if I'm doing anything, cleaning, cooking, I want to put on my music and just.
Girl, I sit in my car and listen to music before just to get right before I have to go into work.
Absolutely.
Before I go into any place,
yep.
I have to listen to a song.
I have to have my music. Like, it's never too early in the morning for me, for music.
You ever had your theme song play in your head? Mm-hmm. Walk into a room. Open the door.
I'm here. Okay, y'all. Well, Nita, do you want to tell us anything about you other than the fact that you're a music lover? Where are you from? What you know?
Born right here in Davenport, Iowa.
Well, I said
I'm an Owens. You know,
yes.
We Owenses. We do our thing. I'm kin to all of Davenport, girl, because mama's a Owens, daddy's a Mosley. But currently, last name is Miss Parker, Meechie Smunchie's wife. Yes, yes.
Let's go.
Yes,
let's
yes.
Go.
Two
Black
beautiful
love.
Young children, or the grown kids.
But they still you are.
Lake and Michaela. Yeah, girl. And babies and grandbabies.
Grandbabies.
All of mine.
Grandbabies.
All of mine. I ain't going to say all their names because it's D-D-D-D-D. Well,
a
there you go.
A lot of D-D-D's. Huh?
Right.
Well, gotta love the grandbabies so you can send them back home.
That's right.
Yep, that part. Well, we ain't gonna waste no time, y'all. We're gonna get right into this music. You know, us music lovers, we do not play about our music, okay? So we're gonna start with our female artists. And to be completely honest, y'all, the female artists, I'm not gonna say I forgot about her, but when me and Nita were talking about what song it was that she wanted to bring, she had about 58 songs that she was choosing from, and she was trying to narrow it down. And one of the songs was from Melanie Fiona. And I'm like, I used to love her. Where in the heck is she at? Where the heck did she go? Like, I want to see her. Like, and then the song that she said, because everybody knows Melanie Fiona for what is it? 4 a.m. It kills me. Mm. 4 a.m. It kills 4 a.m. me. I think her and CeeLo had a song together.
They did.
Fool,
they
I'm a fool for you. Fool, so, fool yep, for you.
That's the one.
Yep.
That's the one my husband
But
liked.
That's not the one that we felt.
Nah.
The mean? One that we felt.
Ooh, wrong side of a love song.
Woo-wee.
Baby.
And honey, when I tell you, when she came out with that, that did something to my soul.
Girl probably did something to her soul too.
That's why she was singing the way that she was. And she was so like, she was just, it seemed like she wasn't here long, but while she was here, she made her presence known. You know definitely. What I mean? She's from Toronto, Canada. I never knew that. Yeah.
Me neither.
And she was discovered in 2002. She was a part of an R&B trio when she first came out, and then she took the solo route and started doing her own thing.
Which people should.
Which a lot of people should. She was a Grammy nominee. And she was top 50 on the billboards at the time when she was popping. So when she was popping, she was popping. She was that girl.
That's it.
And the song came off of the album The Motherfucking Life in 2012.
There you go.
If that tells you anything, right. You already know what type of hits is on that CD right there. But the song is about her just basically saying, like, she's now alone. And she has to face the fact that it's all done. It's you know, and now she realizes that she's on the wrong side of the love song, which is not where anybody wants to be.
We all end up there, though.
We do end up there most of the time, you know?
Wrong side of every damn thing in a relationship that don't work.
In a relationship that you're trying to make work, but it just ain't there. You know what I mean?
Mm.
Giving life to a dead situation. It's just like, baby, gotta let it go. But the part of the song that I felt the most, it was a lot of parts of the song, y'all. I can't lie. Like, damn, I was listening to it and I'm like, fuck, I like the intro, I like the chorus, I like the hook. The whole song I felt, you know, but the part of the song that I felt the most was when she said, I don't wanna be without you, cause I can't hardly breathe without you. This is what it feels to be the one standing left behind. How did I become the wrong side of the love song? Oh, y'all gotta hear her sing it though. Cause I can sing it, but I can't sing it. You know what I mean?
And I can sing it in the car.
And you can sing it when you're rolling in traffic. But really though, the intro, like when she went in there and she said, where were you
when I needed a friend?
Oh my man. God. That in itself, it's like you just listening at this point to see what else she gonna say.
Right.
There go one of our co-hosts. Hey, Nia. Yeah, so again, I'm not Melanie Fiona. She is a phenomenal artist. She is beautiful. Her voice is so unique and is so...
She got so much to offer. She's really deep.
She does.
And I think she felt a lot of whatever was going on with her and her relationships deeply.
She definitely did. And I appreciate for her allowing us to be a part. You know what I mean?
Right.
Writing that music and putting spreading it out the love. There for us. Spreading the love. So, Melanie Fiona... We love you.
Shout out to you, baby.
Of the love song. Thank you for bringing this back up, triggering my memory. Let's go. Just that.
Man.
How it eases on in there.
Yeah, she killed it.
She did. Will you cut this off? I don't know why this is even on.
Where are you when I needed a friend? Thought I could be strong, never knew I'd be so wrong. A heartbreaker
most of my life.
Suddenly all changed the moment you left me. I wonder my life. Tried to play cool, but instead I was playing myself. What you gotta know about me is I'm dying in this lonely house. And I don't wanna be without you, cause I can hardly breathe without you.
That's how I be though.
Right.
Every piece and part of me. You're always the best.
She said this part.
But instead of us leaving you here alone, but I didn't mean it. No, I didn't mean it. Now, baby, baby, come home. And it got me singing, oh, why you wanna make me cry?
I felt that. All I'm saying, y'all, is I felt that. Like, you can't help but to feel that.
Girl.
She took us all the way to another place with this song. Like, you know what I mean? The wrong side of a love song?
Girl.
I don't know.
How do you end up there?
How do you get there?
Shit.
You'll be there and you not even know that that's where you had it. You know what I mean? Or at a place and you didn't know how you got there. It's like, that's a hard place to come out of and to move forward, you know?
In relationships, people get to change their mind when they feel like it. So if it's at a drop of a dime, it's at a drop of a dime.
And once you get there,
I'm coming to get your ass if you leave me.
Hello? I'm coming to find you. No, what's wrong? We finna work this out. Like, what? No, I don't want to be on the wrong side of a love song.
Right.
I want to be in love. I don't know. I don't want to be without you. I can't breathe without you.
It's not another woman out there that don't want to be in love. But I can understand it's a lot of y'all out there on the wrong side.
But won't even move around.
Right.
But content and okay with being on the wrong side of the love song.
I've been stuck.
And it's hard to get out when you are stuck. But you got it's a big step that you got to take. But if you really want, you know, to get out of that situation, you'll do
it. What your mama saying, your grandma's the baby when you're tired. Mm-hmm. When you get tired,
talk about it.
That's it. Them words right there send you off into about 45 more relationships.
I'm trying to tell you.
But when you get tired.
You girl. Don't care. And that's just it. It's over. It's done.
That's it.
And you got to move on, right?
That's it.
And listen, it gets greater later.
Amen.
Big facts. So I felt that. Melanie Fiona, girl, I don't know where you're at, but come out. I would love to see you. I would love to hear from you. We need something. We would love to have it. Holla at your girl.
That's right.
I felt that. Next. All right, y'all. We are already up to our second artist for this episode of I Felt That. And we're going to go ahead and get into our group artists. So the group artist this week that I'm reflecting on is a male group artist. And they came out in 1987. Same year I was born. And they're from New York City. Okay. And the group is called Guy. And it was with Teddy Riley, Aaron Hall, and his brother Damian Hall.
You know what? I never paid attention.
I never really even knew that. Yeah. I don't know why I never knew. Maybe because they was kind of before my time. Right. You know what I mean?
But they all got solo.
But they all went solo. Yeah, they all went solo. And Aaron Hall. I just love me some Aaron Hall.
Girl, my sister was a big fan of Aaron Hall.
Yeah.
Yeah, from Anna.
Yeah.
That was you.
So, and they... their debut album sold over, a million copies? Like, back then, them boys... I mean, I don't know if they can still sing, but back then, them boys could sing.
You know it was that damn cassette tape, right?
You know it.
We bought them all.
All of them. Rewinding, fast forward, like, all that. With that little...
the
rolling
pencil.
It up.
The pencil.
The pencil to roll it up. Like, man, you couldn't... That's what we dealt with back then. Like, we didn't...
Cassettes,
how
baby.
Things have changed,
man. Evolution.
But them guys, Guy, and the song that I'm reflecting on is called "Let's Chill."
There you go.
Let's chill.
Our real first.
Hey,
what them young folks call it today? Because "Let's Chill"
day
was
one.
Good, right?
I don't know what album it came off of, y'all, but the song is about, he's just letting her know that, look, I'm looking for something serious. Let's chill. It's me and you. Let's settle down. We finna make it work.
Because that's what I want.
I'm ready to commit to you. And me and you.
Let's chill. I felt that.
Yes, I felt that. And honestly, that's the part that I felt the most, the chorus part.
Just yeah.
Let's chill. Baby, let's settle down.
Yeah, because he's that little one with that Riley one. He's fine.
Yes, he
yeah,
was.
Yeah, he's fine, fine.
Me and you. So we're going to go ahead and play that. Guy, let's chill. I don't know any other songs from them. Do you know any other songs?
They actually did have another song. I'm probably going to have to look it up. But okay. I know they had something else that was kind of up there. And
that's the only song that I know from Guy is Let's Chill.
Let's Chill is and like
standing
ovation.
That was the main
one
that, yeah. And that's just, it. I love, again, I'm a big fan of men singers. So them brothers singing smooth. You know,
so
and just
might
let
have to
her
do
know.
Another one of these interviews then, because I had them, I had all the guys lined up back in the day.
Well, we're gonna do just the guys only.
Oh,
episode
that'll
we're
work.
Gonna reflect on nothing but songs from the men.
Okay,
okay, for sure. We're gonna
I
do
got
that.
A list.
Okay, she had 58 songs, y'all. I'm telling y'all, 58 songs picked out that she might want to bring on here. And I'm like, she is a music lover for real. Like,
I couldn't pick.
It's too hard.
Like,
too many songs.
I don't
have just say, okay, let me
one favorite artist. I just had a lot of favorite songs off of everybody's, yep. However many
like
albums.
Like, a fan of everybody. Like, I literally am a fan of everybody.
And
like,
I'm a big fan of everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And so, all type of genres.
Genre. That's why I said it don't have like, to just be stick. R&B. Nope. Yeah. If it sound good, catchy beat, some nice lyrics, and it, hey, you didn't want me over, and that's
okay,
it.
Well, I'm gonna put somebody on
for
the map
sure.
Then.
Be thinking, because I'm gonna be thinking too.
Yep.
We're gonna go ahead and get into that. Guy, let's chill. Let's go.
Oh, yep. He's strong with that voice.
That bald head.
Ooh, girl. And chocolate.
Chocolate.
Chocolate. Y'all. Y'all know. For you, I make that sacrifice. So let's chill. Let's settle down. Cause that's what I wanna do. Just me and you. Some of y'all can't count. It's two.
Two. Me and you. It's not three.
Man.
It's not four. It's two.
Right. Baby, these side chicks been getting ridiculous.
And they be too confident in him for me.
Miscount.
You done forgot what role you playing, baby.
Miscount. You can't rewrite, spell, or count. Stay out my relationship.
Yeah, I'm trying to tell you. Right on along.
The song is so chill.
It
I'm
is.
The
it
whole
just,
song.
It is very like.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. You just want to groove to it and just like, okay, it's gonna put you in a good,
whatever you want, I will do. That's what I need you to do. Whatever I want. Only one I want in my life, and I'm gonna do the same.
Yeah,
for
I'm
you.
Gonna do the same.
For you, I'll make that sacrifice. Let's chill. Hey, let's settle down, cause that's what I wanna do.
Just
me and you, let's chill.
Let's chill.
Girl.
Okay.
Now we out here. I felt like this.
Yes.
And think about the
What I realized about old school music is the songs were longer.
They were a whole lot longer.
New school is very much short.
Yep, I just talked about that on episode 5 about, can we get some songs that's more than 2 minutes?
They serenade.
An intro, an outro, 2 verses, a chorus, 2 times. Like, we need that.
They serenade.
But now they rush through it. It's like, can you let us get a feel for the song before you just started singing and gotten us feeling it, and now it's over.
Girl.
I
promise you, as much as I thought I was in love with in my teenage years, baby, I had an album of my own.
Yeah.
You heartbroken every other week.
Don't even know what you're doing.
I don't like y'all.
All I'm saying is I felt that.
Hey.
And, you know, I don't know. He said the first time I saw your face, he knew he had to have her.
That's love.
That's love. Like, sometimes you know, you just know.
That's love.
That's love. And I felt that. That's all I'm saying.
Don't let that face change, though.
Because it can change.
Because, baby.
If it changed.
I done heard it all.
But sometimes you can automatically tell it's going to be something special. You know what I mean? You get that feeling. Like, when you first see them. You know what I mean? It's like, you know, like, this
when
is somebody
you know.
I want. Exactly.
You know? And they say, you know.
Love at first sight sometimes is a real thing.
In this lifetime, if you meet your one, you better hold on to it.
You better hold on to it.
So, that you ain't gonna now, get it your again. One, you can be a fool for.
And you could be a fool for that one.
I'm a fool for my one.
For that one. What did Melanie Fiona? I'm a fool. I'm a fool. Her and CeeLo, go listen to
right.
that. But
yeah, very good one.
You can. You can be a fool sometimes for the right one.
For the
if
right
they give you the right reasons to do that. You know what I mean?
Girl, I'm going out loud for my one.
Hello?
I'm going to do stuff I ain't do for all the rest of them. Oof.
But you can tell when it's not the same, when it's something genuine. You know what I mean? You don't have to worry about, it's not forced. It's not, you know, you don't have to make them do anything. They do what they want on their own. You don't have to tell them what to do. They know what to do.
That
it's just
part.
Like, you know, that's how you know it's something real. And like, okay, you in tune with me.
Right.
You paying attention to me. You know what I mean? You care about how I feel. You care about, you know, what right. I'm thinking and all that.
You don't know your real colors.
Nothing
what
about
you, like, what part of your body to touch to make you break all the way down.
Hello?
You probably ain't the one.
Talk about it.
I ain't finna keep leading you to the goddamn.
I don't have time to be teaching you me. Like, take the time to learn me. Take the time to learn me on your own. You know what I mean?
That's it.
And if you ain't got time to do that, you can keep moving.
Yeah.
That part. So, I felt that.
That's the energy right
that
there.
For real. All 2024.
Y'all been drinking this dirty Mississippi water. Can't figure it out.
You got to figure it out. Don't even trip.
Little yellow school bus.
Beep, beep. Next. All right, y'all. Believe it or not, we're down to our third artist. And here at I Felt That, when we have a special guest, we let them bring their favorite song on. And they get to tell us a little bit about the artist and about the song and why they felt that. So I'm going to let Nita go ahead and get into who she's bringing and what song she's reflecting on.
So we're going to do Luther Vandross.
Little Luther or Big Luther?
Oh, girl, Big Luther.
Big Luther.
You know what? I heard that he actually tried to lose weight the healthy way. So.
Well, that's good because Luther, a lot Luther. Of people, yeah.
Well, there you go.
Luther.
And his song that I chose is I Rather. And the reason why I chose that song is because before I married my husband, Munch, he sung this song to me.
Aww. That's so, and that'll always have a different type of meaning for you.
It
you,
will.
You know what I mean? Because that's so
girl,
heartfelt.
And he can sing.
Oh, he can sing?
Yeah, he can sing.
Okay. I'm going to get him on here.
You're right. You come need on him here. On here because I don't have it. So that album that I Rather came out in 2001.
Okay.
And it's called Eponymous.
Okay.
And I might be saying it wrong, but it's literally a love tribute to a woman who he left.
Okay.
And he went with another woman, and he was just like,
realized
oh my God.
The grass wasn't greener.
You're right. The grass
way.
Just wasn't greener.
It wasn't what he thought it was.
It usually isn't.
Normally it's not.
You know, you be there are women out here that could subjectively mimic the previous woman, but she can't be.
Never will be.
That part.
Because you ain't gonna never get that original.
That it. That's it.
That's it.
So,
when did Luther come out?
They said he was discovered in 1981.
Okay.
So he was part of, you know, a couple of groups and sing on other people's stuff.
Okay.
And then his sister brought him to the Apollo. So he's from New York.
Okay.
And she was part of a group.
Back then.
Yeah.
That was the place where a lot of talent got recognized and, you know, discovered.
Yeah, and she was in a group, a song called My Juanita. So I knew dang well I was on the right
track. This is it here. This is it. You on the right track.
That's it.
So, yeah.
Okay. So what part of the song on I'd Rather did you feel the most?
You know, I love this part so wholeheartedly. And I'm going to sing it to the best of my abilities. And y'all can hear the song.
Do what you do.
But he said, and then I met someone and thought she could replace you. We got along just fine, but wasted time because she was not you.
Oh!
There what? You go. I felt that shit.
I felt that. Because what? Because I wasted time because she was not you. You
he
only
said,
get one me.
Girl.
That's me. One me.
One. The original
copy. I
don't
care what anybody else might look like.
DNA,
what they
baby,
might
don't
sound
lie.
Like. It's on me, baby. He said.
And he went on to say, we had a lot of fun, though we knew we were faking. Love was not impressed with our connection, built on lies, all lies.
All right. You better say that. What?
There you go.
Now you know
I had to rethink it, reiterate. Oh, my God.
Though.
You know, these people don't be out here thinking they got you on something, but baby, you didn't have this one, baby.
Not this one.
This the original copy right here. God only made one, baby. You can't copy me. You can't have nothing that I ain't give you. I didn't give that to you.
Talk.
The Lord sent it back.
Tell it. He sent it back. This is for you. This is for you. It ain't for nothing. He for me.
Listen
he
to
mine.
The song.
Ain't this nobody
might,
else's.
Right. This might coordinate with you.
And you might be able to relate, and I'm pretty sure somebody
right.
else felt that.
Just make sure you have your husband sing it to you, not mine. Oh. There you go.
That part. With that being said, we're going to go ahead and let Luther sing his song, and I don't really know what else to say.
Right.
She needed and did what she needed to do, and she understood the assignment. She came on here. She said what she needed to say, and I got to play this shit right here. Let's go.
So fast.
I thought some time alone was what we really needed.
You was wrong.
You said this time would hurt more than it helped, but I couldn't see that. I thought it was the end. Of a beautiful story.
Ooh.
And so I left the one I loved at home to be alone.
Ooh.
And I tried and found out this one thing is true, that I'm nothing without you.
Hey.
I know better now, and I've had a change of heart. I'd rather have bad times with you than good times with someone else. I'd rather be beside you in a storm than safe and warm
yeah.
by myself.
Yeah.
I'd rather have hard times together than to have it easy apart. I'd rather have the one who holds my heart.
Such a beautiful song.
It is. He thought that shit through. He was crafty.
He definitely did.
Okay. And what'd she do?
And thought she could replace
and could.
You. And couldn't.
We
come
got
close.
Along just fine, but wasted time because she was not you.
Juanita.
We had a lot of fun. Though we knew we was faking.
Cause she a fake one.
Love was not impressed with our connection, built on lies,
all lies.
So I'm here cause
Yeah, I'm petty as hell.
It's time for her to get up out of here, man. Mouthful right there, Luther. Oh man, you got to keep it real. He kept it real on that.
He really did.
He did. He kept it real on that.
I felt all the emotions through that song. Mm-hmm. You know, the happy, the up, the down, the ins, the outs. Mm-hmm. Ooh, I felt that.
Yeah. And it takes a mighty man to admit, you know what I mean, to be able to actually say, like, look, I tried it and she wasn't, you know what I mean?
Man.
Like, people don't like admitting their wrongs or actually saying that, you know, speaking on a situation that they know they was foul about.
People get so busy looking outside of their relationship for something that's already there.
It's already there. You already got it. You know what I mean?
And they always
Why are you
say
seeking
you don't
other
know
places?
What you have
until
it's gone.
That is a true statement.
So,
like,
man,
you got to feel that.
I felt that.
And Luther, you brought that. You brought that on this. Like, oh.
And you put homeboy back on the map.
For real, for real.
You on that.
He didn't. You gave that man a chance.
He didn't sing that song to me, baby. I don't know where we'll be right now. I don't know.
He understood the assignment.
The man.
And he did what he had to do.
He thought
it through. I'm happy he did do it.
Well, you were thank you.
He knew what he needed to do.
You and me both, girl. Because I married that man so quickly.
Hello.
I'm like, Lord. Hey.
Let's make it work.
The man.
Hello.
As y'all know.
Yep. It's not easy, but
it
is possible.
That's it.
Love always wins. For sure. I felt that. Ooh. Good song choice. Thank
I
you
know,
for bringing
right?
that on there. Thank you for bringing that. I felt that. Next. Y'all, I hate to say it, and y'all know this is my least favorite part of the episode, but we're down to our last song. Like, you cannot make me believe that it's almost time to wrap this episode up. Like, time flies when you're having fun and when you're
That's
talking
it.
About good music. Like, music lovers, I could literally sit and do this all day.
Me too.
Literally.
Me.
Yep, I literally could.
I could listen to about 1,000 songs.
For real.
A day.
I probably do.
I know I do.
For real. So we're going to go ahead and get into our last artist. It is the new artist for this week. We do love our old artists, the ones that brought us through the good times and the bad times, but we do got to show recognition to the new artists that are also on the scene as well.
Okay.
So the artist that I'm reflecting on now is a female artist, and her name is SZA. Is that how you pronounce it?
SZA.
I've been saying SZA. If it's wrong,
S-Z-A.
I'm sorry. But it's a very weird spelling.
We still
and I don't
love
really
you.
Know.
We still love you. We listen to your music, so.
Hey. We love you. I'm SZA. It's gonna be SZA season today.
They're right.
Whatever come out, I'm sorry, but she is from St. Louis, STL.
Okay.
She's a singer-songwriter. She actually was discovered in 2011, but her debut studio album didn't come out till 2017. Mm. The album from the song that I'm reflecting on came out in 2022, and it was called SOS. And I'm assuming that stands for someone special.
But I don't hope so.
Yeah, I hope it is. If it's something else, somebody let me know.
I think most of the music I've heard from her is probably someone special.
Yeah. So... again, that was on 2002, and the song is called Snooze.
Oh, okay.
And it's catchy. It's catchy. A very beautiful song, and it's, you know, it's just about her letting him know that she's all about him, basically. You know what I mean? She said, I touched that fire for you. What? Right. She let him know. Hold on. On the way in.
That lets you know that
that's the energy.
He was putting
that,
it down in that room. I don't know. Listen.
Come on now. He do what he do and in there, and she said, I'm going to touch that fire. Okay?
She touch fire. I'm
talking. Ride or die. You hear me?
Right.
She's just you is important. Okay? Damn. You is kind. You is important.
There you go. That part.
Have you speaking like that. Like, yeah. He doing what he need to do. Just leave it at that. But yeah. And she's just letting him know that, you know, I'm down. Like, this is it. I'm all in with you. And the part of the song that I felt the most, I believe it was the chorus. She said, I can't lose when I'm with you.
Okay.
Something
about the moment. You is so important. Something about, you know.
Nobody like you.
Right. Nobody does my body like you do.
Yeah.
Something like that.
Nobody does.
I've listened.
Yeah. But my main part was just saying, I can't lose when I'm with you.
That's all I know. I'd be in the car like
that. But I do like that. And when she went in, when she said, I put the fire for you. That,
right. I heard that. I'm tuned in.
What else you got to say, SZA? Right. Come with it. Like, I want to hear the rest of it.
SZA.
S-A-S-A. I can't
do it. S-Z-A. Shit. I think she hit that shit.
She hit that shit on there.
Yeah.
She did her big one on that one. And then she got a few other... she got a few other songs that she had. I can't think of them right now. Can y'all think of them? No.
Only the Stars that she, you know, that, with Kendrick.
Yeah, with Kendrick Lamar.
So it was,
but yeah, this
she,
one.
But yeah, she, yeah, she's got some, oh, there's some other
she
song.
Got a few other ones.
I was going to say, she...
The Weeknd, yeah. Again,
see,
yeah.
Oh damn, she was. Yep, she's on that one too. I like that song.
Yep.
Okay.
Okay.
I love the Lord.
Okay.
I don't know about that one. But I know about
Listen.
We're gonna go ahead and let SZA sing her own song, because I am SZA. I can't even remember the words at this point. We've been drinking, y'all, and it's the end of the show. And we're gonna go ahead and let her do her thing. SZA, let's go.
I knew that dream was something, and I testified for you. I swore that I like you, that bitch I knew it. All the while I was cheating, I got it. Long as you joking, that went for me. I got it, my bitch, she didn't do it. I know it. Long as you dreaming about me, ain't no problem. I don't want nobody just for you right now. But the truth, I look better under you. I can't lose when I'm with you. Nobody like you do. I can't lose when I'm with you. I can't snooze and miss the moment. You just so important. Nobody like you do. In a cocktail bar with you,
right.
I feel like Scarface.
Right.
Take this like you did there to my face. She said she feel like Scarface.
That's it.
It was magic, yeah. Magic gravity, yeah.
Okay. That's why I'm going karaoke tonight.
We need to figure out what they're really saying in these songs.
Right. It's one of the moments where you just be like, she can sing.
She can sing. Yep.
When I'm with you, so can I snow and miss
the moment. You just do more than nobody, nobody like you do.
Like, you I can see myself dancing to, if I want to be cuddled or dance.
Right.
You know?
It can put you in both moves, you know?
Right.
Yeah.
Aww.
All right, SZA. All I'm saying, SZA, is I felt that. She's just saying, ain't nobody like you, period. Hands down. I'm not going to play with you or about you. You important to me, and that's just it. And I felt that.
That's how you have to be.
Straight to it, you know? She said, listen, I touched that fire for you. That's a big deal. Like,
if I'm going to touch that fire for you.
You better
be on my team.
You already know I'm
standing
behind you. Like, exactly. You better be on this side right here.
Man.
This is the only side. Not the wrong side. The right side.
Come out with the...
Hello? I'm just saying, I felt that. We felt that.
Definitely
felt
that.
Y'all,
Ooh,
it is the end of episode 7 of I Felt That. Y'all, I want to thank Nita for coming through and blessing us with her favorite song.
You are so, girl,
listen,
blessed.
You are welcome. I appreciate you stepping by and rocking with me and vibing with me on this episode.
Yeah.
It's been a complete pleasure, for sure.
I have too much fun.
Good. So that means you're gonna come back,
right? Because
we already doing that episode with the men, right?
That's it.
Okay.
That's it.
And then, like, one of my guests was like, "I want to bring a song." She said, "But I don't want to do a love song." And I got to thinking, like, you know what? There's plenty of R&B songs out here that's not related to love, even though those are my personal favorites,
right?
You know, but it's a lot of songs out here that we could reflect on that don't necessarily have to do with love.
You know what?
That's what makes it best for me. But again, I love
a lot of different views on different every genre of music. Mm-hmm. It's horrible. Mm-hmm. Today's music is a little different, but you can probably reflect with my kids about that.
Yeah.
But my old rappers in my day and age, where you can actually sing the song with them and rap with
them.
And
you know what they were saying?
Yeah. You know, I could probably bring some
stuff. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. So it's gonna get deep here, and I feel that. Just stay watching and stay in tune, okay?
Yeah.
Right now I'm gonna go ahead and let Nita go into, she has some business talk that she wants to put out there for us, and she's going to leave some of her contact information. So I'm going to go ahead and let her get into the details on that and let us know what she got going on.
All right, so coming up for summer of 2024, we Meaties Munchies Italian Icy. All you guys know my husband Demetrius Parker. We call him Meaties Munchies Italian Ice. Y'all have his Facebook page. We are coming back out with the same flavors from last year. The only ice cream that we're going to probably do and promote really big and heavily, because it was a big seller, was that Laffy Taffy Banana. So, all right. That part. That's how we was, too, back there with the little, you know, that banana Laffy Taffy go hard.
Yeah, everybody love banana, but that's not my favorite.
I wanted to add some new flavors to some stuff, but I think what we're going to do is keep our Italian ices that hit really big last year. So we know that watermelon, all the reds that y'all knew is coming back. The blue.
It
kind of reminds you of kind of the slushy machines that was at the 7-Elevens when we were younger. But because of the consistency of it,
mm-hmm.
it's like an ice cream with no dairy.
Really?
Yeah, it takes that form.
So you guys mainly do it more so in the summertime, right?
In the
right?
summer months. Okay. So the summer months, we reflect back and jump back in. It's hard to do it in
the winter.
So we'd
be expecting you guys to get things like started.
I would say he would be ready, if not the first week of June, the second week.
Okay, for sure.
So look us up. You already know we're sitting in front of Five Below. Okay. Check the page.
On Kimberly.
Yes.
Okay. East Kimberly and Davenport, Five Below is where they're going to be posted up at. Y'all go get y'all some Italian ice.
Thank you so much.
Oh my gosh. And because that's my favorite thing to do, especially in the summertime. Like, you want something just to keep you cool. Mm. And me, I'm big on flavor. So them flavors, I can't wait. I cannot wait.
There's so many different flavors. I know he probably liked this. I got you, babe.
Yeah, for sure. So you said, what is it on Facebook that we can look up?
Meechies Munchies.
Okay, and that's M-E-E-C-H-I-E-S?
Yes.
Munchies. On Facebook. Look them up. Y'all be ready for the summer. They're going to be out here with all the good flavors posted up, waiting for y'all to come and spend some of that good money.
That's right.
Let's do it. Quiet Cities, we got to collaborate one another, okay? We got to quit competing and support one another. It's not going to hurt y'all to support one another. It's enough money to go around for everybody in here.
That's right.
Or around here to get some money. Like, it ain't no need for us not to be supporting each other. Like,
y'all go share her everything. I felt that. Go on, come up here and do an interview.
Listen, come on up here. Like, if you a music lover.
Man. Come on.
We got to talk, man.
Because I'm going back to work and inviting all my white friends. She's going to learn some country music.
I already know some, so listen, I might be teaching them some.
Me too.
For real, I'm a music lover, okay? Like you said.
Support her.
Genres.
You see this, just do better.
Hey, just come and be a part of it. It's, again, it's a wonderful thing. This is just something that I love. It's a hobby for me. You know what I mean? But I'm a people's person anyway, so I love linking up with good people, genuine people that, and then to connect on something like music that means so much to me, and now I see how much other people have a love for music. Man. That's what does it for me. Just being able to sit here, talk about it, reminisce, bring back some memories, laugh a little bit. You know what I mean?
It
That's what it's all about.
Sanity together.
It definitely does. It's good for your mental health. Let's talk
That's
about it.
It.
It's good for your mental health.
Definitely let's talk about it.
So again, thank you to everybody that tuned in to this episode. Again, I want to thank Nita for stopping through. Shout out to all my day ones that's been out here with your girl ever since I started this thing up. If you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel, please subscribe, y'all. Like, comment, share. And guess what, y'all? I felt that.